Rose, like rosacea.
Do the wink at the end, I'm really into it. Hey, I'm Nahal.
And I'm Rose.
And this is Skin ID, where we break down overly complicated skin topics.
Let's get into it. All right, so what does skin redness actually mean? Like, how would you define it?
I look for three main things when I'm identifying skin redness. The first one being like dryness and flaking.
I typically think of irritation when, you know, maybe you use something that's way too harsh on your skin, that's really stripping its natural moisture barriers, or something just too harsh.
And blood vessels. Sometimes you just get these broken capillaries right here and that redness just sticks around for a long time.
And I'm sure we've all heard of rosacea too, which also causes capillary or blood vessels getting bigger and redder in your skin. And we'll address all of that later, so stay tuned. Okay, so how do we manage and soothe skin redness? Well, the first thing that I would recommend is checking your skincare products for things that are just too harsh that might cause the redness. So one of the biggest things that I look for is alcohol. Denatured alcohol dries out your skin and really can irritate it. The second thing is like chemical exfoliants, physical exfoliants. So like we're always trying to find these cleansers with like these little beads in
right?
there,
yeah.
Which is fine. But also if you have skin that tends to get red, that's probably not the best thing for it. And then the physical exfoliants are like the rotating brushes that you can clean your skin with.
Super
harsh.
That
can be super irritating, especially if you're using it once a day, twice a day. And last but not least, products with added fragrance. Fragrance really irritates the skin.
Yeah, it smells good, but
it smells so good.
So when it comes to what products to use, I look for a super gentle cleanser and a really hydrating moisturizer. You want something that feels good and keeps your skin super hydrated.
And last but not least, sunscreen. Sun damage can cause so much redness in the skin. It can break your little capillaries on the surface of your skin and just create this never-ending redness on your cheeks. So sun protection, that means sunscreen every single day, and physical protection such as hats, sunglasses, gloves, long sleeves.
Cover it.
Rosacea is technically incurable, but there are things that you can do to help with the redness. So for example, at Curology, we have topical ingredients, prescription only, such as metronidazole and ivermectin, mm-hmm. and these things really, really help with that texturized, bumpy feeling sort of rosacea that's caused by something called Demodex. There are also in-person procedures that can help with the redness, such as IPLs, lasers, or other topical products that your dermatologist can provide for you. Another cause of persistent redness might be something called eczema. So you may have heard about it. A lot of us suffer from eczema, but it's that really dry, rough, sometimes itchy red skin. It happens a lot during the wintertime when the temperatures are cold and the weather's just really dry. Oftentimes you see it on your face. You can have a patch of it on your neck,
elbows,
knees, head, shoulders,
knees,
and toes. So for mild eczema, you're gonna wanna make sure your skin is very adequately hydrated. So we're talking about a very gentle moisturizer.
Petroleum jelly is great.
Just something really thick and creamy that you can like put on your skin. And it's super important to put on these moisturizers right after you get out of the shower when your skin is still damp, because that's when it seals in that moisture. Super important.
Very important. No, absolutely.
You can also do something over the counter like a topical steroid. Hydrocortisone is a very popular one that you can find in your drugstore. You definitely don't want to use it for too long. Your skin might become addicted to it. So we always say, don't use it for more than like 3 days. Twice a day is all
you need. Just to kind of get the redness under control. But yeah, eczema is a lot about keeping your skin super hydrated as much as you can, so we kind of avoid those times. But when you do need it, we might need a little bit of steroid to kind of control it, but
calm it down.
Yeah.
It helps it out a little bit.
For
sure. It speeds up the recovery process.
Or the redness can be caused by post-inflammatory erythema. So your redness can be caused by post-inflammatory erythema, which is also called PIE.
PIE, not pie.
Don't say pie.
Never
say PIE. And this is the redness that kind of stays behind and lingers after acne. And I know it's a big problem because patients always bring it up. Most people think it's scars. They're like, I have scarring. And I'm like, that's not scarring. Depressed scarring is scarring. And I'm like, this is just the redness that's left behind. It can be brown or red, like the dark spots.
It will go away usually within about, what, 3 to 6 months?
Yes.
Sun protection is key.
For sure.
And honestly, you guys, the best way to avoid PIE is to prevent breakouts from happening.
Absolutely. And then if you do have it, you really need to practice your patience, like just meditate, you know, bring the patience in, because this is gonna take a little bit of time, but it will go away.
Okay, so today we got really into the typical types of redness, what you can do to help soothe it, maybe how to prevent it.
And if you ever have any questions or comments, please drop them below.
Don't forget to like and subscribe, and also hit that little bell below so you're notified for the next time we drop a video. So we can keep making this sweet, sweet content for you guys.
Sweet, sweet content. Love it.
All right, until next time.